Peace. What's up, Mopar fans? Militia911. I know it's been a while since I made a video, and I know a lot of you guys have been waiting for this show that I'm doing, but there's still a shitload of snow, and it's hard to do any of that stuff, obviously, when everything's wet, and there's still salt all over the road, and whatever. But anyways, I have a cold air intake installed in the truck now, an Airaid, and tunes are all loaded up. So, thought I'd take you guys for a little cruise, show you what this bitch is all about now. And I gotta tell you guys, if you haven't got the Diablo tuner yet, and you have 2009, 10, 11 Dodge, get that tuner. What it does to these trucks is unbelievable. Really deep, throaty, tons of power now. Very impressive. It's nice out right now, it's plus 6. So everything's melting. Not bad for February. Gas, $1.99 a quart. That's what it would be to you guys in the States. $4.40 a gallon. So just out of curiosity, how much you guys pay for a gallon for fuel? Just a regular grade 87 octane. Challenger. I'm gonna buy a Viper. I haven't told you guys yet, but I might as well drop the secret. Got a little over a year and the Challenger's paid off, and then Viper time. So I know it's not right away, but we're talking $120,000 here. So when the car's paid off, so is the truck and so is the other car. So then we can buy a real toy. But other than that, just enjoying the new house. And I'll still give you guys a walk around video. I got a little bit of renovations that I'm in the middle of, so I gotta do a little bit of painting and stuff first, and then when I'm done the painting, then I'll make a little walk around video. I sold my little Sony camera, my little handy cam. I sort of wish I still had it just for those walk around videos. Because my EX1R is like not the latest camera for walking around and shooting little short videos and shit. It's easier to be set up on a tripod, but then I gotta stage every shot. Can't walk around with it because it weighs like 50 pounds. But, rips, man. Right now I got all the traction control and everything shut off. But it sounds so much better. TV and I saw Gillette has new razor that's white and green. I want it. So that's what I'm doing. I'm going into the city to buy a fucking razor. Something to do. The wife is at work, so what else can I do, man? I can't sit around playing Xbox forever. Go out of my mind. I hate slow ass driving. Wish you could do like a buck 20 everywhere. But if they got it, we'll buy it. And if they buy it, we'll save it. That's what I have to say. Alright. Peace, I'll be back. That's what I came here for. That's a cool fucking razor. I got problems. A fucking maze driving through this parking lot. Stop sign, turn here, stop sign. Fuck. The dumbest layout I've ever seen. Yes, I don't know about you guys, but Tim Hortons is taking over the fucking world around here. Can't go anywhere where there's not a Tim Hortons. If they're not in the States yet, man, they're coming, I tell you guys. Say goodbye to your Krispy Kreme and Dunkin' Donuts. That's fucking retard. traction control fully off is I don't have any ABS now. So if you're hard on the brakes, then I might slide or spin or, you know what I mean? Like, it'll lock them up instead of slipping them like it should. But it sure is fun. Have those fucking rumble strips on the side of your white line in the States? I fucking hate those things, man. Not necessarily in a town. I get it if you're on the highway and they want to make sure you don't fall asleep so you're nodding off. Right? That's supposed to wake you up. But in town, it's fucking annoying. Who cares if you cross the white line a little bit? At least if they're going to do that, put it a couple feet off the white line. That way, if you got to scoot over because the car's over too much in your lane or something. You know what I mean? It's like they don't think this shit out. Stupid motherfuckers. Have one, get one. Ram RT, funnest truck in the world, I swear to God. Peace.